Hello, thank you for joining the Healing Unicorns Tarot Ministries channel. Today we are going to do a general reading for the water signs. Okay? Water signs, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. All right? For the water signs, please, and thank you, Wakakadash. What messages do we have for the water signs, please? Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Oh, no. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, please and thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. What messages do we have for the water signs? Please and thank you. We have love. The Lovers. We have Mischief, the Devil, and we have Lunar Dragon, the Moon, okay? Okay, for the water signs, please and thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. What messages do we have for the water signs, please? Alright, so in the past, there's some type of relationship here. Someone needs to tread lightly with, they should have treaded lightly with. There's some type of connection here, okay? With the love card. Risky communications. Here with the mischief card here, representing the devil, there's some type of secret, some type of illusions here. Some type of lie, some type of deception here, trickery, okay? Presently, somebody may be going through some type of deception here, and in the future, this will be illuminated. There's some type of illusion that wants to, some secret that wants to be revealed here with the Lunar Dragon, the Moon. He has the Moon in his hand, okay? You know, took it from the sky. Clarification for the water signs, please, Ruach HaKodesh. For the water signs, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, please and thank you. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, please and thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. What messages do we have for the love, the Lovers, Dragon, the Love Dragon? We have the Ace of Pentacles. Clarification of the Lovers. We have the Four of Wands here. That's lit on top of the Lunar Dragon. So what I'm getting, what's so far, I feel like in the past, there was some type of relationship that someone deemed as successful here. Maybe they just found out. Or they didn't know in the past that they found out that at that time, this person was within union with someone else. This was a secret that either They're currently married. They're currently still married, or in the past when there was this relationship with this person in the past, this person didn't know that they were married at the time. The Eight of Cups. Okay. So, what I'm getting is maybe this person found out when they got into this relationship with another person that they thought would be successful here. They thought it would be a windfall. This person may have been financially stable here, but they didn't know that this person was within union with someone else with that Four of Wands. They didn't know that. But I'm feeling like once they found out, they walked away from that relationship. They ended that relationship after it was exposed, or they're currently in a breakup. They walked away from this person in the past, and it's currently right now being revealed with the Lunar Dragon that this person is married. They're in a union with someone else. Clarification of the Mischief card, please.
Till I overflow, I wanna flow over.
Okay, we got the Moon card with the Unicorn. Okay. Clarification of the Mischief card, please. We got the Eight of Swords here. Somebody's trying to break free here. Somebody wants to break free here. But one misstep can be very dreadful here is what I'm getting with this Eight of Swords here. So currently right now, I'm saying tread lightly because this is on top of the Mischief card, the Mischief Dragon here, which represents the Devils, number 15 in the Major Arcana. So there's some type of lies, some type of deception here presently that you're dealing with, water signs here. And there's a secret, there's some type of illumination that's happening here for you. This secret, you may have found out about this union in the past here, but there's a secret that's been revealed here. And presently, Ruach wants you to tread lightly here with this Eight of Swords here. There's somebody stuck in their mind here. They're trying to break free from some type of bondage. But if you can see, this snake is wrapped around their swords. And one wrong step can end this person's life here. This snake's life, excuse me. Or cause some type of serious damage, some serious mental damage. There's some constraints in the mind as well. Somebody's going through something over and over in their mind here. They can't see too clearly here. They're exhausted mentally here is what I'm getting. They don't know what direction they want to go in. They don't know if they should even move or stay here. Clarification of the Mischief card. We have the Four of Swords sideways. So yes, somebody doesn't know what they want to do here. They don't know if they want to rest and move forward here, or if they want, they don't know if they want to rest or continue moving, continue fighting, continue with this mental spar here with this Four of Swords. Clarification of the Lunar Dragon, please, Ruach HaKodesh. We have the Six of Cups here. So this is someone from your past here. This could be male or female. It is a woman on the card. Okay. So this secret here about this relationship that somebody walked away could be a secret with a woman here, or it could be somebody from their childhood past, a past relationship. A childhood relationship. Clarification of the Lunar Dragon, please. We have the King of Wands. We have the Queen of Cups, and she came out sideways. We have the Knight of Swords at the bottom of the deck. So what I'm getting here with the Luna Dragon here, this King of Wands, and this Queen of Cups, I feel like this person from your past is still trying to come forward here. They're still trying to connect with this Queen of Cups here. This could represent you, or it could represent the other person. So either Queen of Cups represent a water sign as well. So you water sign females here, you could have some air sign. I'm not an air sign. A fire sign, excuse me, with this King of Wands here. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius here. That is from your past. That's trying to reconnect with you here. But be careful with this relationship, because I feel like this person didn't let you know previously in the past that they were in union with someone, or they are still in union with someone currently right now. There's some deception going on here. They may be in a separation period with this Four of Swords sideways with their significant other, but they are still in union with that person here. You may see this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. You can see this person as a lover, somebody who is a soulmate towards you. Y'all have some type of deep connection, some type of union here. And you see this person as successful. You see this opportunity as successful. You see this opportunity as a windfall here with the Ace of Pentacles. And you may currently want some type of union with this person. You want some type of marriage, some type of proposal here with this person. But with this Eight of Cups here, and you may have had a relationship. Like I said, I feel like you had a relationship with this person previously, but they were married, and so you ended it with them. And I feel like you're trying to rekindle that union again, but presently there's some type of lies and deceptions that's going on with that union. Okay, clarification please, Ruach HaKodesh. Clarification for the water sign, please. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Please and thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. Clarification of the Lovers card, please and thank you. We have the Hierophant sideways. Ten of Wands. The Six of Swords. And the Four of Swords at the bottom of the deck. So what I'm getting here is that I feel like you previously in the past waited for this person to end a marriage here. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, water signs. You possibly in the past waited for this person to end this union here with this court, this Hierophant sideways, and the Four of Wands, which would be next. that became burdensome with this 10 of wands here. There was a road that someone was traveling down that they couldn't see too clearly on. They couldn't see in front of them or behind them here about this union here. And they were waiting for some type of intervention, some type of government, some type of ruling to come so that they can get their Ace of Pentacles with this relationship here. And then and the future of this relationship is Eight of Cups, the walking away, ending of a relationship. And somebody with this Six of Swords here, when they're leaving, they're going to leave suddenly, and they're going to try to block out what they're leaving behind here. They don't want to address it. If you can see, she has her eyes closed here, almost wishing on a star, as if she has a genie bottle in her hand. She's trying to forget whatever it is that she's leaving behind. Maybe get away from this relationship, okay? Yeah. Clarification of the Mischief card, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKodesh, for the water signs. We have the King of Swords here. Clarification of the Mischief. Clarification of the Mischief card, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. We have the Six of Pentacles. We have the Seven of Wands. Okay. The secret is, I feel, that whatever it is that you can't wrap your mind around, that you can't see clearly on, is if this person is coming back into your life presently to what are they here in your life for presently. And what I'm getting here is that there's some type of financial entitlement here, some type of financial benefits here, with this King of Swords here, this intelligent man, this man who knows how to use his words to get what he wants. He's tall, handsome, dark, gallant here, strong. Okay, and you can't make your mind up about this person right now. You're resting. You don't know if you want to rest or if you want to move forward here. And in the future, we have the Seven of Wands in reverse here. So what I'm getting here, there's some type of defeat here, some type of loss. Okay, that you can't make your decision about in the future if you want to move forward with this person here. In the future, we have the Seven of Wands here. So there's some type of loss here. It could be financial loss here. I don't know. We have the Two of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Like I said, there was a lack of clarity. There's a lack of balance here. And Ruach is asking you to get your clarity, or this secret here, this information that you're receiving right now with this Eight of Swords, is to help you make this decision here with this Two of Swords here in Judgment. After that, Hermit, Seclusion. Okay, so yeah, I feel like this person that's coming back into your life here, that's mischievous. They're not being honest here. This King of Swords has a secret. With the Moon card. They have some type of secret here. And I'm feel like it's that they are in union with someone else. That they are already married here. They're not being honest about that marriage. They may be separated from that union. But nevertheless, they are still in union with this person. They're still in union with this person. Clarification of the Lunar Dragon, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. We have the Eight of Wands in reverse. There's some type of delays here. The Empress. The Lunar Dragon, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. We have the Seven of Cups here. And the Page of Pentacles at the bottom. With the Death card next. And Strength. So what I'm getting here is that what I'm getting here is that there's some type of illumination about this person from your past, okay? This person may have not approached you yet, or they're thinking about approaching you here. And this is some type of illumination that's happening for you, that's divinely guided for you, okay? Six of Cups is right underneath it. This Eight of Wands here, there's some type of message that is delayed here. Some type of information is being delayed here. Some type of communication is being delayed here. You may possibly have this person blocked or whatnot. This person from your past here. And we have the King of Wands with the Empress here. With this Queen of Wands. That's sideways here. For the future. This person is married. Or there's some type of motherly figure that's heavily influencing this man here. It could be a baby mother. It could be a sister. Okay. And I feel like this Queen of Cups represents you, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio here. And I feel like with the Seven of Cups, this Queen of Cups is looking towards the future for whatever she desires, whatever she lusts after, whatever it is that she truly wanted to manifest within her life. And she sees success in this King of Wands. That's what it is. And you feel like if you wait long enough for this person to divorce their current wife here, that you will somehow be able to reap this harvest, to gain these things that you desire here. This Queen of Cups that is sideways here. She feels like this is her time in rising. This will be her rising time to accept, to gain whatever it is that she truly desired here. In the past, you walked away from this person. I don't know if this is perfect timing that you feel right now to pursue this relationship, but I will say this person is still in union. they're not divorced here. They may be going through the court procedures. They may have some court dates. They may have filed here. But it's not in reverse. It's not in reverse. It may be coming to an end, this court situation. It may be coming to an end, but the union card was still upright here. So there may be some settling in court here because it's facing towards the west. So the sun may be settling. So this court situation may be settling. This decision may be settling. About to reach settlement here. But they're still in the process. This person is still married. Okay. Clarification, please. Ruach HaKadosh, what messages of healing do we have for the water signs, please? Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Clarification of the lovers, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKadosh. Omens. I bet you thought that I was broken. I won't. Clarification of the mischief card, please, Ruach HaKadosh. It was new beginnings, but it flew out on the floor. For the mischief card, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKadosh. We have truth. Ancient wisdom. And integration. Clarification of the lunar dragon, please. And thank you, Ruach HaKadosh. We have grounding. And then we have an inner journey at the bottom of the deck. So what I'm getting here is that this relationship, for how it was, the illusions, the deception that started this relationship is bringing omens, okay? It's not beneficial towards you, okay? There's some type of attachment, some type of negativity that comes with engaging into this union here. As I was saying, risky commitments, treading lightly here, okay? Being able to look at what is, being able to decipher what's true and what's not true, okay? Instead of being what they call that, being captured by the glitter, okay? With this Ace of Pentacles here. Okay? And with the mischief here, the truth is, what I just told you about this man here, this King of Swords here, that's sitting on top of this moon card here, the truth about this man is that he's still in union. He's still married. He's still currently married to someone else. And he's coming forward with deception, with lies here on top of the mischief card, which is the devil, number 15. Okay, and he's using some type of knowledge here, some type of mental control here, because I told you with this Eight of Swords, somebody being stuck in their mind, they can't make a decision clear. They're intertwining themselves into a trap, a mental prison here. They don't know what to do. And one wrong move can end in a disaster here. In the end of one's life, life as they know it, currently here. And the ancient wisdom that's being given to you is that they're doing this for financial gain here, for financial entitlement here. This person may be acting like as if they're a giving person, but they give grudgingly, okay? They don't give willingly. They don't give with a happy spirit, okay? They give with a nasty attitude about it, okay? With this Four of Swords, this person that you can't rest on, this person that you don't know what to do with here, that there's some type of false victory here, there's a falsehood here. But you're going to have to learn to integrate whatever it is that you're learning about this in order to move forward, okay, in your success. Integrate the wisdom that you learn, integrate the truth that you learn, okay? You may be working with someone, you may end up working with someone here. And yeah, it becomes a collaborative group effort here, because we did have the Empress and the Queen of Cups touching one another. Okay. And then we have grounding here with the Lunar Dragon. So it may be possible that this Empress and this baby's mother, this wife, or this mother, whoever this is, this sister, it could be a sister, mother, baby mother, a wife, this person may end up collaborating with this water sign female who is acting in an almost karmic mindset as well. She is focused on her desires and what she wants, her lust, her temptations. But they may, if she gets grounded, they may come together, okay? Because I do see some blockages here. They may have one another blocked here. If they can ground themselves, if they can get balanced and grounded into the earth, they may be able to come together and work together as a collective and whatever kind of court system before this court system ends, before this decision is made here, they can come into collaborative effort and gain some type of success that they truly are desiring. With this Seven of Cups here. Okay? Alright, Ruach HaKodesh, what unicorn messages do we have for the water signs, please? Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces. Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, please. Please and thank you, Ruach HaKodesh. And what came out? Partnership. Okay? Partnership unicorn came out. What's at the bottom? Goddess. Goddess partnership. Okay? I just said that. Okay? And the partnership says, teamwork will give you a better result. Find trustworthy people to partner with. Build up a talented support team. Okay, Ruach is on it. Okay, and I was just saying that if, excuse me, if these two women, this karmic female, this Queen of Cups, the one that was having this affair with this married man, with this this Empress husband here, which is the King of Wands here. Okay, fast action man here, a man of desires, a man who chases after his desires here. I told you that there was some type of blockages going on here with this ace, this Eight of Wands here, some type of delays of communication with this person from their past here. So this Empress and this Queen could possibly have this person blocked. But I believe this queen is the one, this wife, baby mother, is the one that has them blocked. But if these two women could come together and get grounded and focus on what they truly desire, what they truly want here, and not what they're being so selfish here, they could come together and manifest what it is that they both want from that King of Wands here that was on this table that is playing tricks and not being honest here. Okay, he's basically cheating on his wife here. But they have an opportunity in the future if they can ground themselves, if they could put their personal differences aside and not battle against one another and turn that, focus that energy and turn it towards the true culprit, the true person who is bringing this deception, this devil energy, that mischief dragon here. They will succeed. They will have success. It's up to them though, okay? And with that, I'm going to close this out, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Have a good day.